How do you cram 25 years of accomplishments into just a few minutes? The answer is you don't.
But our pal Eric Perkins is leaving Care 11, so we wanted to share with you some of the fantastic moments that we will never forget, both on the air and off.
Welcome to the SRI, the first ever snow removal invitational.
From the moment he crashed, ran, rolled onto the scene, you just knew Eric Perkins was different. And we mean that in the kindest, most special, complimentary way. Just ask the guy who hired him.
There are some vintage Perkett Place stories that when I was the sports director and he was the reporter, literally crying, laughing so hard on the set that somebody was that creative to pull that off.
Here comes the pain!
No, not the pain. Randy. I don't like this assignment.
Ah, yes, the three words that made him a Minnesota household name. Perk at play.
Bullet football right there. Oh, sorry.
There really isn't much Perk didn't try over the years.
Peter. Eric, that's not even speeding on the highway.
Sometimes he made it out unscathed and sometimes not.
Dislocated your jaw.
I did?
His job, of course, was to cover all the teams and the big names in town.
I see you got your own show now. You big time, Perk.
And we looked forward to his trip down south every spring.
Coming at you from Fort Myers, Minnesota Twins, spring training.
Because covering sports for Perk isn't just about the hits, runs, and errors.
That's the mower of love.
Should I stay or should more know now?
I always feel like Ron Gardenhire's watching me.
And he is.
Ah, the voice of an angel. But singing isn't his only talent. Yeah! Perk legit signed a contract with the Swarm. He played something like 8 seconds in one game. He then served a 2-minute bench minor. You can do the math on that career. But let's do the math on some of his other accomplishments. He's covered Super Bowls, the Vikings in London, and 5, count them 5, Olympics.
Welcome to the Athens 2004 Olympic Games.
And lest you think Perk is one-dimensional, we assure you he is not.
Perk has a couple of minutes every newscast to do sports, but you give him 2 hours on a Saturday morning show and the wheels come off.
For many years, Eric and Belinda hosted the Saturday morning show, including some epic Halloween episodes.
I hear something at the door.
Tis medieval times, didn't know we had a doorbell.
He also co-anchored the weekend evening news, even if it was a bit late for him.
We melted half of our ice.
You made Perkins fall asleep.
No, reflection on Sven.
Then there were all the behind-the-scenes trips to famous NBC shows. Who could forget the combination of Perk and Jimmy Fallon?
Yeah, partying, partying, yeah, bun, 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 bun.
He even performed the opening skit and hosted the regional Emmys.
Lemmy! Win an Emmy.
Emmy update, Eric did go on to snag a few of those statues. Yep, he's talented and funny and strangely tall, but he's also a big guy with a big heart.
I love kids and I love helping kids and I love instilling in kids that this notion of charity and helping other people.
Eric and his wife Shelley started Perk's Pinky Swear Mess Fest to benefit the Pinky Swear Foundation. He has raised a lot of money for kids dealing with cancer and their families over the years.
Oh my gosh!
Great job.
And not once, but twice, he bested his on-air buddies in the Care 11 food fight, raising money, food, and awareness for Second Harvest Heartland. And his feet certainly won't forget the time he and a coworker broke the world record for longest singles tennis match, raising money for Relay for Life at Gustavus Adolphus College. It lasted, get this, 36 hours, 36 minutes, and 36 seconds.
It's absolutely awesome. We're in the books. I mean, it's just like, that is just, you cannot take that away from us.
That big heart leads us to the best part of Eric Perkins, the guy we all know when the camera isn't on.
The thing about Perk that I love the most is faith and family are so incredibly important to him.
He will do anything for his family. He goes to great lengths. He is a tireless father, and it's something I've always respected about him, even more than his work on air.
There is no one like him. I mean, no one. He just lights up the screen and has so much energy and so much talent.
You can't be in a place like this for 25 years and then leave and not leave a hole. And not just with all of us here, because we were around him every day, but I think for the viewing audience too.
Let's call it a day.
He's amazing.
Well done, Rena.
Yeah, Rena, well done. That was not easy. We have a lot more Perk on the way. We so wish his family could be here tonight for the send-off, but unfortunately we have COVID safety precautions at the station.
So weather's next, but here's a message from the Perkins, Shelley, Jenna, George, and Maeve.
Dad, I'm so proud of you.
So my dad has been working at Care 11 as a sports director for 25 years, but he is still the least athletic person I know, but we still love him.
I can't wait for you to spend more time here. Home.
We are just so proud of you and all that you have done, not only at Care 11 for 25 years, but in this community as well. All the lives you've touched, all the stories you've told. But like George said, we just cannot wait to have you back home.
Love you, Dad.
Love you, Dad.
Love you, Dad.
Congrats, EP.